Hello, my name is Adrian, and I'm an engineer here at Keysight Technologies. In this video, we will be looking at an impaired wireless LAN signal using 802.11a standard to demonstrate advanced and specific demodulation troubleshooting techniques. When troubleshooting, there are three key analysis techniques that when put together form a troubleshooting process as observed in this diagram. In this video, we will be looking at this advanced troubleshooting analysis. The general approach is to look at different measurements and deduce an error. The first thing we do is look at the symbols in the errors table. We notice that the value that most stands out from what's expected is the symbol clock error, which is fairly large. We also know that there is something wrong by simply looking at the constellation. In OFDM signals, there are many impairments that can cause the constellation to have this behavior. Moving along, we see that the error vector spectrum has a V-shape, with the error getting larger as we go away from the sensor. Looking at the error vector time trace, we see that the error gets worse as we get farther along in the measurement as well. Next, we can look at channel frequency response, which seems fairly normal. Putting everything together, we know that we have an error that is frequency and time related, and we know that our symbol clock error is strange. The symbol clock error, in fact, can cause the behaviors we see in the time and frequency domain. The reason is that in EV spectrum, we set the center of the spectrum as a reference point. And with the symbol clock error, the subcarrier spacing gets changed. As we go further away from the center, the spacing gets larger and larger, and that's why there is a larger error at the edges of the spectrum relative to the sensor. With EV time, as we measure successive symbols, the clock error is getting bigger. This causes bigger errors as we measure out in time. We can test this hypothesis because our software allows us to define what the subcarrier spacing is. To calculate the subcarrier spacing, we multiply the current spacing by the symbol clock error to maintain the proportion, and then decrease the original spacing by this product, since it is a negative error. In this example, it means decreasing the spacing by 4 Hz. When we change this, we see that the EV spectrum and EV time traces are much cleaner, and the symbol clock error goes way down near to zero. Alternatively, we can fix the signal by enabling track timing. The software can track symbol clock timing on a symbol by symbol basis based on what we measure from pilots. By enabling track timing, it is essentially taking what we have measured as our symbol clock error and corrects based on that. Here we have many different selections for correcting. However, the standard is very vague about how measuring equipment should be correcting the signal. If the standard doesn't specifically say that something should be corrected, then our product will show it as the error. And if it is desired to correct for these, then we provide options for the corrections as well. Thank you for watching this video. For more information on any of the topics mentioned in the video, please consult the VSA software's help files.